Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today in wonderful Banished here in the town of Boulderline, where we are going to try once again. This is the ongoing issue in this series, trying not to starve to death. Okay, goal number one, don't eat your friends and turn to cannibalism. Having a cannibalistic option in your town to feed some people, okay, that would be a cool mod. Anyways, what I'm doing in this episode so far is we are constructing a stone road that goes around the marketplace. This is going to help all of the market workers and shoppers walk faster. We're also going to try to upgrade the roads to and from our farms and our most distant locations. Very important tasks to do. So let's start here on this very edge, and we're going to try to link it up with our group of farms that are way out in the middle of nowhere. The reason for this is even though the farmers can take all of their crops to this barn, which is oh so convenient, we have to take that food back to town somehow, and that's the job of the vendors. So since we have a limited number of vendors, we want to make their speedy process as efficient as possible so that the food is not stuck in limbo, so that everyone can eat and be happy. And in doing so and trying to connect these, it appears that I have missed a little bit of a spot, and I've built a road where no road needs exist. So we will have them simply remove that little piece and try to pick up the trail again. It is like hidden behind all of these trees. Right, I think it just goes in a completely straight line up to that point. And I don't think we ever connected a road to our main village from here. Okay, well, see, this is why I am going over all of these little patches of land and road, because we haven't even completed this little connection here. So it's definitely a worthwhile endeavor to try to do so. Okay, I can't go through there, so we're just gonna go simply around the side and try to drag as straight a line as we can all the way up here. That should be efficient enough. One little length of road is good. We should have enough room for a home in here. Yep, four spaces, and we can squeeze another one in on the outside if we want to as well. So some options there. Hopefully, see these people right here. This is who I'm talking about. These vendors, the 63-year-old laborer, bringing some food and wares to the marketplace to deposit. And now she's gonna gather some food and go eat for herself. Let's see where she takes it. Just follow the life of Clayton, the 63-year-old educated laborer. I love just following my people around. Look, she lives close by too. And that reminds me of something else I wanted to show you. Over here next to the farms, we can see that our homes are actually being used for their intended purposes. Two farmers living here, two farmers again, just a whole bunch of farmers now finally living next to the farms as I originally intended. So that's gonna make work more efficient because they don't have to go very far to get to work each day. Some other things worth keeping up to date on. We've got a full quantity of fuel. 655 firewood right now. That's a lot of firewood, so we are definitely going to up this. Let's just up it to a cool 500. That's going to remove quite a bit of firewood so that they can continue working. Let's check on our brand new fishing dock and see how they're doing. 308 fish currently caught this season versus 579 from this dock, so we'll have to see how the next season compares with both of these being so close together, if it even matters at all. So three fishing docks in total. Hopefully this will all help. We're up to 1,500 food, which is great, but that's mostly because of the harvest. So now they're going to have to grow crops anew, and we're going to have a little bit of a shortage again. So a little scary, but it's okay. I have faith in the wonderful citizens of Boulderline. And just one final thing. We may as well create a nice stone road leading back into town from the west coast. Let's just drag it all the way down here, and we'll eventually fix up all of these roads sooner or later. But we'll get them to work on that. That is a huge straightaway that would be very useful to have as a stone road, so they'd be walking so much faster. I don't know why I divvied it up in there like that. We'll fix it, okay? Guys, don't worry. Aesthetically, it'll change. Now, let's make a new structure, a brand new building, after we see what the trader that just came into port has to trade with us. Nothing of interest, just a whole bunch of food and beans, but you know what? Let's trade a little bit. We have excess of firewood, so let's just trade 100 firewood for... We could get some mushrooms. That doesn't sound terrible. Let's get some plums, right? Let's get 300 plums. Why not? We'll take your food, dismiss you, be on your way. You guys ready to make a new building? There's one in particular I have my eye on. It is a steeple. It is a chapel with a steeple, and it's going to complete the look of this town. Just look at this beautiful structure. Oh, that is awesome. And to make this even fancier, we're going to place a couple wells in front of it. I know that this is going to be a lot of stone materials and resources that we don't have, but Italics is lavish, right? I like spending my resources and spending my money when I really don't need to? Why have two wells in front? Why not have two wells in front, I say? So let's get this chapel underway. Let's see what it does first. It provides happiness for the devout and a place to meet and worship. See, it wasn't all in vain. This way, a road that's along the side of the wells will be there. So it'll just make it look better. Trust me, it'll look better to me at least. We're gonna put this on pause for now because it's gonna take 130 stone, which we don't even have enough yet for the wells. So we're gonna go ahead and place it there and get it ready to go. I think it just fits really well next to the graveyard. And it's just going to even out the town even more because we have so much going on over here in the town center, as it were. And yes, we are going to make some more homes and houses on the outskirts to the east. Meanwhile, our investment previously in the schoolhouse on the island is proving very valuable, as the other schoolhouse is completely full and this one is nearing completion of 20 students. That's crazy. So we've got 34 students in total. Let's check on our total population out of curiosity. 172 citizens. Food is still trying to stabilize. Look at that spike. This is where it hit almost rock bottom right here. It shot back up with the harvest, and now it's kind of dipping back up, going around. It's going crazy right now, but hopefully we will get that straightened out, and hopefully we will eventually have a surplus over here back at the sheep pen. We're putting out 200 mutton per season, 30 wool per season, and this season we've got 400 mutton, so that's even better. Hopefully we will find some new animals next time a trader comes in that sells some animals. I've decided that to help our stone cutters out because they're having so much trouble producing enough stone for us to make not only all of the stone roads that we need, but also we're gonna have to collect 130 here. Let's get some of our extra laborers working on resource collection. It's been a while since we've had to use this, but I think it's worthwhile because we're gonna collect all of the stone around this gatherer. And the purpose of this is twofold. Not only are we gonna be collecting stone for building, but we're gonna be removing all of these excess materials that are just getting in the gatherer hut's way. And we can also add another forester if we want here to grow more trees. And that's gonna increase the efficiency of the gatherer as well. Lots of options. So let's open up our workers and professions and get some more miners going in here. So four more miners is going to be good because two are going to split off into each. So we're going to get two more coal miners to help produce more coal, making 200 per season. This is a difficult balance to maintain, as you can probably tell. It seems like both of our wells have been created and the roads are still in need of construction. Our builders are very busy, it would seem. Let's go ahead and unpause construction of the chapel, so that everyone can start clearing away these trees, start placing down the resources that we do have. Almost 90 stone right now, so it shouldn't be too long before we're able to afford the chapel itself. And since we probably have, ooh, look, a merchant. All right, pause the game. Since we probably have an excess of laborers right now, let's go ahead and add one more builder to total out at 4, and please have something great for me. A bunch of steel tools. This is the first trader I've seen that sells coats and tools, so that's interesting. But I, of course, prefer seeds and animals, but that's okay. We can probably take some of these tools since we are running so low. He's got 100 of them. They're 10 apiece. Let's take 20 tools. That's going to be about 200 in total. So if we just take about 50 firewood, that should be an even trade. I like that. All right, and we have plenty of clothes right now, so we'll just take the tools and be on our way. We have a few options for food. The option that I'm going to choose to take is going to be to make a second cornfield. That's going to allow us, even though it doubles up on the resources, we're going to just have an extra farm producing an extra 1,400 corn per season. Give us another boost. So one day when we get another seed, we can always change what it grows. So there are options with that. We may as well go ahead and get the pasture being made. Oh, baby, would you look at that? Doesn't this look glorious? And it's complete. We just witnessed the chapel popping into view. Zero members. We can have one person working in the chapel. Oh, wow. The membership just spiked in the chapel. Record numbers attending church in Boulderline. All members, actually, 173. What you guys didn't realize is that I made a law in Boulderline while you weren't looking that every single person has to attend church. That's just the rule. We got one cleric who's going to be helping to maintain the chapel and bring happiness. We can take a look at this beautiful architecture. I designed this myself, of course. You know, I laid every single brick off screen just to make sure it was as pretty as possible. For some reason, this little cobble is a different texture than this little cobble. Don't know why that is, but it's okay. It's okay. We can always put a little road around it just to make... I don't know what I'm doing, okay? That's just what I do. We just do stuff and things, in the words of Rick Grimes. Super excited about the chapel. 174 members. Just once it fills up, I guess that's just going to be every single person in the town is going to go to church. 200 seats, no more, no less. Italics is decreed that everyone shall go to church. Ooh, a new trader. A new trader with cattle. With cattle. It's got cattle, guys. The trader has cattle. How many cattles can we afford? I am so close to being able to afford four cattle. And while I'm waiting on the last of these materials to be brought here, I've just been watching these fishermen. I'm just like, guys, I gotta train them. I gotta teach them how to catch whatever he's carrying, right? Like, that's what we need. All right, please don't leave, fisherman. Please don't leave, trader man, whatever your name is. There we go. Four cattle now belong to Boulderline. Okay, guys, go. Cast your line. Catch whatever he's got left. Go catch some sheep. And just reel them in. It'll be okay if the little sticky thing sticks the sheep. It'll just catch them by the wool. It won't hurt them at all. All right, so we have... What? What? Gertrum the herdsman was trampled by livestock. That's impossible. The livestock are all pinned up right here. Don't go in there, Brienne. They're dangerous. They might trample you like they trampled Gertrum the herdsman. Don't ever let me catch you inside the pen with the livestock again, who can apparently trample people while not even trying. Alright, so we've switched the pasture over to be cattle. And watch as the smart cattle travel through the sheep pen into their new home of this small pasture. There's one smart cattle. Where are the rest? Oh, they're swimming across the river. Here they come right now, following their leader. Oh, they have arrived. Hopefully they do not die off like the sheep. This guy's over here, Erold, has probably replaced one of the herdsmen as well. How many herdsmen, in fact, do we have? Two out of two. Is that really all we need? Okay, great. That's apparently been full this entire time. So we've got four cattle right now, and we're going to make seven in total. So the reason I got so many was just to jumpstart this process, and I need to be very careful because we do not want to store all of these clothes again and all of this fire. We definitely don't want 500 firewood. 150 is good for now. And we'll store another 150 iron. Why not? Okay, so yes, once we get seven in total, we will be able to start harvesting them and taking their delicious meats. I don't know if they produce milk or what. I guess we'll find out when we see what they are producing. But for now, I am just excited that we finally have another animal, something else to contribute to the food source every year. But we're going to harvest them for delicious beef, and then we're going to send that beef over to the tavern, and the tavern's going to make delicious bacon cheeseburgers. Actually, we can't make bacon because we don't have any pigs. Dang it! Maybe there'll be a bacon cheeseburger mod. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this new episode of Banished. We've made lots of progress in some areas, and in others, we've kind of stagnated. I've just now designated this to be a new cornfield, so hopefully they will start planting for the next season. We'll probably need to assign some new farmers. We're going to have so many farmers, it's not even funny. Now we've got 12 extra laborers. We have no wonder I can't keep my people fed. They're filling up all of the houses and homes that we've been creating. That good news is, though, is that we can make some more miners. So let's go ahead and fill up the whole selection of miners. So now every single task should be working at 100% efficiency, which is great. We even have too many builders. 10 laborers now. Oh, amazing, amazing. Very happy with the progress that we've been making. Brand new in this episode, cattle, a chapel with 173 members and a new cornfield. And I'm also going to continue to work on upgrading our roads to become very efficient, very pretty stone roads. And again, stone houses. And you know what? Why not just go ahead and make another stone house right here? So that's going to be upgrading. Let's see how the upgrade system works. Yeah, oh, it makes them homeless. Today I learned they have to be homeless. You kick them out of their homes. Okay, well, now we learned. If you're enjoying Banished and you want to see more videos like it in the future, please support this series and all videos that you like by leaving a like on the ones that you do. Thank you so much for watching. Follow me on Twitter, link in the description of this video. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time in Boulderline.